Liv Morgan is another case of hard work paying off in the end, because over the last few years, she's gotten way, way better, culminating this year with a big payoff. Liv's 2022 started in the hunt for the Raw Women's Championship. At the end of 2021, she began chasing Becky in the belt. She would have a shot against her in December on Raw, but would fall short. She would receive another shot at Becky in the championship at the Day One event, falling short yet again. She failed to become number one contender for Becky in the championship at the Royal Rumble, so she would enter the Royal Rumble match itself. She would last 37 minutes in the match, but didn't eliminate anyone and was eliminated by Brie Bella. Liv entered the Elimination Chamber for a shot at Becky at WrestleMania for the Raw Women's Championship, but she would lose there as well, being eliminated by Alexa Bliss. No longer in the hunt for the Raw Women's Championship at the moment, Liv Morgan started teaming up with Rhea Ripley, and they went after the Women's Tag Team Championships, challenging for them at WrestleMania, but losing there. Ripley turned her back on Liv, starting up a mini-feud between those two. Ripley would join the Judgment Day. AJ Styles was feuding with the Judgment Day, so Liv Morgan started teaming up with AJ Styles to go against the group. That feud came to an end at the Hell in a Cell event, with Liv and AJ losing to Judgment Day. But after that feud, Liv went right back into Women's Championship contention. While losing contenders matches for the Money in the Bank event, she would qualify for the Money in the Bank ladder match, which she would win to become Miss Money in the Bank. The same night, continuing the tradition of women's Money in the Bank holders cashing in on the same night, Liv cashed in on SmackDown Women's Champion Ronda Rousey after her match with Natalya. Liv got the quick win. She became the brand new SmackDown Women's Champion. Now on the SmackDown brand, Liv entered in a feud with Ronda over the SmackDown Women's Championship. They had the rematch taking place at SummerSlam, controversial finish. Liv would tap out, but the referee didn't see it. The referee only counted the three. Liv retained the SmackDown Women's Championship. It was around this time when, as is always tradition, the fans began to turn on Liv. With Ronda off of TV for a bit, Liv took on Shayna Baszler at Clash at the Castle. Liv got the win to retain her belt. Ronda earned another shot at the SmackDown Women's Championship. Liv Ronda would take place at Extreme Rules in an Extreme Rules match, where Ronda got the win to become brand new champion, but Liv didn't tap out, she passed out with a smile on her face. Liv began to snap, acting a little more crazier since losing the title, but it seems that's gone somewhat on the back burner after her and the returning Tegan Nox started teaming up. They went after the Women's Tag Team Championships, but they did not win them. Overall, 2022 was the biggest year yet for Liv Morgan. Miss Money in the Bank, Women's Champion, a little crossover work as well, achieving one of her dreams of being killed by Chucky the Killer Doll, as at the end of an episode during Season 2, Liv, as herself, got brutally stabbed to death by Chucky while he says his 10 allotted F-bombs per episode. Hopefully in 2023 they go more into crazy Liv Morgan, because that has a chance to get more over than her being the scrappy underdog, because come on, who doesn't dig crazy chicks?